Hi everyone, welcome back to the Behind the Scenes series. Today, I'll walk you through this time lapse on the Balanced Scorecard Dashboard. If you'd like to see the dashboard in action, click the link above to explore its full functionality. All the resources are available for download in the description, so you can follow along step by step. Now, let's dive in and start building with a blank Power BI file. First, we'll bring in our data from Excel. Simply select the file, choose the worksheets you need, and click Transform Data to enter the query editor. For the pillar table, Power BI did not detect its row headers. Click on the button Use First Row as Header to correct it. Then click on Close and Apply at the top left corner to load the data. After loading the data, we will head over to the model view. Power BI automatically detects relationships between tables based on matching fields. Double-check these relationships for accuracy to ensure proper data interaction. Back in the report view, we'll load a custom background for the canvas. At the Format pane, select Canvas Background and choose your image file. Adjust the transparency to 0 for a crisp look. Next, we'll work on the dashboard title. At the Home ribbon, click on Text Box, choose the font style, size, color, and type Balanced Scorecard. Then format the text box for size and position, and remove the background for a clean look. Center align the text too. Moving on, we'll create a measure table to organize the measures. Click Enter Data, name the table Measure Table, and click Load. Right-click the measure table and create a new measure for weighted score. Then, delete the unnecessary column 1 in the measure table for a cleaner view. We will now create all the necessary measures for this dashboard. To keep things concise, I'll fast-forward this section, but you can find all the DAX formulas in the BI template. After we are done creating all the measures, let's work on the first visual. It is using big number to show the overall weighted score. Insert a new card visual and add weighted score to data field. Format the card by first resizing and repositioning it. Remove the background. Then set the font size to 60 and alignment to center. For the label setting, reduce the space to 0 before disabling it. Next, update the card setting. For padding, set as custom to remove its top and bottom padding. Turn off the background and border too. To add clarity, we'll include a label using the text box. Set the font style, size, color, and input weighted score. Format the size and position of the label. Then turn off the background. Let's move on to the KPI visual beside. Insert the first table visual and add KPI name and KPI status as columns. Rename the field for clarity. Open the data pane and apply a filter using the KPI pillar field. Set it to P1 for the first pillar. Next, resize and reposition the table to ensure it aligns properly within the layout. Reduce the top and bottom padding to remove any extra space, and turn off the background for a cleaner look. For the grid, set the horizontal line to white and width to 10. Then modify the border color to white and increase the row padding to 4 to enhance the row spacing. Under values, set the alternate background color to white. For the column headers, reduce the font size to 9, set to italic, align to center, and turn off auto size width. Also disable the totals. Under specific column, for KPI, set alignment to center. And for status, change the text color and align to center too. Next, we will apply conditional formatting to the KPI status. Go to cell elements, select status, and activate the background color. Configure the first rule for on track, along with its corresponding color. Then proceed to set up the next rule for below target and apply its color scheme. Finally, manually adjust the column widths to ensure they fit neatly within the table's dimensions. With the first table complete, duplicate it for the next pillar. Simply update the filter selection to P2 and position it in the second quadrant. I will now repeat these steps quickly for the remaining two pillars. Now, we will add the pillar name for each of the quadrant. Duplicate the overall weighted scorecard and replace the data field to header. Then update the card filter by adding pillar as the filter. Set the first card header to P1. Next, format the card size and style. And remove the top and bottom padding. Set the font size to 20 and update the color. Duplicate the card for the next quadrant. Then adjust the filter to match the correct pillar. After that, reposition the card accordingly. Repeat these steps for the next two pillars. All right, let's add the line between the header and table to enhance the design. Go to Shapes from the Insert ribbon and select Line. Adjust its size and position. Turn off the fill and update the border color. Duplicate the line for the next quadrant and reposition it nicely below their respective headers. Repeat these for the next two quadrants. Now, as part of the dashboard design, we will add colored shape behind the KPI count. Under the Insert ribbon, go to Shapes and select Rectangle with Rounded tab for both top. Resize and reposition it. For the shape style, increase the rounded top corners to 50, change the fill color, and remove the border. Then enable the shadow, adjust the transparency to 57, and blur to 26. Finally, rotate the shape to 90 degrees. Next, duplicate this shape for the quadrant below. Reposition the new shape. Then update its fill to the quadrant assigned color. For the two quadrants on the right, duplicate the shape again. Reposition it and update the fill color as needed. Then, rotate this shape to 170 degrees to align with the dashboard design. Follow the same steps for the last quadrant. The dashboard design is nearly complete, with only the KPI counts for each quadrant remaining. We will reuse the overall weighted scorecard by duplicating it and replacing the data field with count KPI. Similar to the other cards, open the filter pane and add KPI pillar as a filter. Set P1 for the first card. Next, we will format the card size and position. Then adjust the top and bottom padding. For the callout value, reduce the font size to 28. We are done with the first card. Duplicate this card for the next pillar, updating the filter for P2 and reposition it to fit nicely at the second quadrant. Repeat these steps for the next two pillars. I will speed up the video here to save time. With that done, we've reached the final dashboard component, which is the info icon above the weighted score. Duplicate the weighted scorecard once more and update the data field to info. Resize and reposition the card. Then, remove all padding to eliminate any extra space. Reduce the font size to 11 and set a lighter color. Under Cards, adjust the left and right padding to 0. The dashboard is now complete. Hovering over the info icon or the KPI table should reveal additional insights. To enable this, we'll set up the tooltip details. Start by renaming the current page to Dashboard. Then click to add a new page. Update the page name to P1 and type to Tooltips. Set the canvas type to Custom and adjust its size. After the tooltip canvas is set, insert a new card visual and add KPI name, KPI details, KPI metrics to the data field. Rename the fields for clarity. After we are done, open the data and filter pane. Then add KPI pillar to filter for P1. Next, we will reposition and resize the card. Adjust the left padding to 14, top and bottom to 0. Then remove the background. Change the card layout to single column and set the space between the cards to 0. Update the value font size to 14, then format the label by setting the font size to 11 and space between label and value to 0. After that, adjust the card settings by setting the padding to custom, which allows you to reduce the top and bottom padding. Turn off both the background and border. Once completed, duplicate this card to display the weighted score. Remove all the data fields and replace with weighted score. Then rename the field to score. Next, format the card size and position. And proceed to remove all the padding. Also, update the value alignment to center. To keep the color scheme consistent, we'll set the label color to yellow for this tooltip assigned to P1. For the card, reduce the card padding to 0. Then turn on the background, update the color and adjust the transparency to 76. Now, let's set up the bar chart by first creating a dummy table. Go to Home Ribbon, click Enter Data, Input Chart for the header, and Actual, Target, Variance for the value. Name the table chart and click Load. Then we need to create the measures for the chart. Right-click the measure table and create a new measure for chart value. I've already set up the other measures, so I'll fast-forward to keep the video concise. You can find all the DAX formulas in the BI template. The next step is to set up the chart. Insert the line and clustered column chart. Add chart to the x-axis, chart value to the column y-axis, and add actual, target, actual 2 to the line y-axis. Then expand the filter and data pane to add KPI pillar as a filter. And set P1 for this tooltip. Next, format the chart by adjusting its position and size. And increase the left padding. Then update the title and match its text color with the score label. Also reduce the spacing to 0. After that, click the ellipsis in the top right corner of the chart to sort the axis by chart, then click again to sort in ascending order. With that done, update the x-axis font size to 12 and turn off the title. For the y-axis, disable both the value and title. For the secondary y-axis, enable align zeros. Then, toggle the value on and off to ensure it doesn't appear on the chart. From there, remove the legend for a cleaner look. For the columns, set the actual bar to the assigned pillar color. Next, update the target bar to gray. And set the variance bar to white. In the line settings, update the line style to dotted and width to 2. Following this, set the color to gray for each series. After actual, move on to target and finish with actual 2. Next, activate the data labels. Under All Series, disable the value. Then select chart value at the series, set the position to inside end, enable the value, and replace the field with variance value. To display the variance line on the chart, we will use error bars. For actual, enable the options and select the fields upper bound 1 and lower bound 1. Then, under bar, set the border size to 0 and under marker, increase the size to 6. For actual 2, enable the options and select upper bound 2 and lower bound 2. Then, under bar, remove the border size and under marker, increase the size to 6.2. Finally, adjust the canvas width to 428. Now that all the tooltip elements are in place, we will duplicate this page for the next pillar. Rename it to P2. At this point, we'll update all the filters to P2. Start by selecting the first card, opening the filter pane, and setting it to P2. Then, move on to the bar chart filter and update it to P2. Lastly, update the scorecard filter to P2 as well. From here, we'll change the tooltip colors to match the assigned pillar color. Click on Callout Value and change the label color to orange, which is the designated color for pillar 2. Also, update the card's background to orange. For the chart, go to the title settings and change the text color to orange. Then update the bar color by selecting column and changing the color field to orange. That completes the tooltip for P2. Repeat these steps for the tooltips for pillars 3 and 4. To save time, I will speed up the video here. Following that, we will insert a new page for the info tooltips. Update the page name to info and type to tooltips. Set the canvas type to custom and adjust its size. Insert a new text box, choose the font style and size. Then input the formula. Format the text box for size and position. Once completed, return to the canvas and resize it to ensure a proper fit for the text box. We've completed all the necessary tooltips. Now, let's link them to the dashboard components. Select the info icon card, navigate to Properties, enable tooltips, and set it to the info page. Then, hover over the info icon to confirm that the weighted score formula is displayed correctly. Next, we will link the tooltips for the KPI tables. For the first quadrant, select the table, enable the tooltips, and choose P1 as the page. Now, hover over the KPI table to verify that the tooltip displays accurately. Repeat these steps for each of the remaining quadrants, making sure to select the corresponding tooltip page for each one. This will ensure that each quadrant displays its relevant details when hovered over. And with that, we've completed the step-by-step guide on building the balanced scorecard dashboard from scratch. If you're looking for more dashboard tips and templates, be sure to check out my earlier videos. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you in the next video.